Hi everyone and welcome back. And in this video we are going to talk more about JavaScript array questions. So my first question here we are talking about: this object has been given to you and you have to remove the duplicate IDs. We have already worked on removing the duplicate characters from a string, removing the duplicate numbers from a integer array, all those sort of questions. Now this is an object, okay? So it will be same. What we need to do is we need to create some empty array, and we need to just iterate onto this array object, okay? And we can use the map provided by JavaScript. So this map is available in JavaScript, and now what we do is we will run for of loop const item of array. Okay, we are running a for of loop and we will just check if map has that element already. So there is a method map.has, and we are iterating onto the item, so item.id. If that is there, then what we will do is, if that is not there, then map.set. Here we will set item.id. We will just put item.id as true, so that if once it has been iterated, we will not iterate onto this again. And we have results.push, and we can just push the object. So it should be simple item. Okay, and what is this, right? So we have a map. Once first iteration is coming, what we will do is, it's not available in the map, so we will set it. So next time when you are getting the same ID, this condition will be false. We will do nothing. We already pushed this element in the results, and we are good to return the results. Okay, so results will have unique IDs from an object. Okay, that is very basic. Now next problem set is, we are going to talk about maximum profit problem. Okay, so this is also related to array. Like, consider that you have been given an array, and you have been given an array of stocks, like stock prices, which can be a random array, right? So consider that this is an array and these are the stock prices. Okay, now we need to find out the maximum profit and minimum price. Okay, so first we have to find out the maximum profit. These are the stock price which you got from today's trading. Now we need to call a method, getMaxProfit, and we just need to pass this array. Okay, before that we have to define this function, and we have to find a max profit from this const max profit. It is taking array as an argument, so this is a price array, you can say. Now the basic conditions to check: price array dot length. If this length is less than 2, that means we have only one read, right? So we can just say return throw new error. In JavaScript it can be like this: getting max profit requires max greater than equal to 2 elements. Okay, after this condition, let's assign mean price and max price. We will create a variables. Min price is price array of 0, and max price we will just assign the difference of price array 1 and price array 0. Okay, so first possible max profit will be this. So this is price array we have from first index to 0th index. This is the initial max profit we assume, and minimum price also we put. Okay, now what we need to do is, we need to iterate onto this array. we got the max profit and minimum price. We just need to set min price properly by iterating, and we need to just keep comparing max profit while doing iteration. Okay, so for let I is 0 and length equal to, you can say, price array dot length. This is my statement, so I will just check if I should be less than length and plus plus I. Okay, after this, sorry, it is not accepting. Okay, these are two statements, and we can start with I equal to 1. Length equal to I is price dot length. Yeah, that is fine. Now here we will calculate max profit. So price array of I minus min price. Now we will calculate actual profit, actual max profit, by doing this min price. If this is comes out as a max profit, right, that means there is a max profit or exist somewhere, right? Max profit equal to price array of I minus min price. I mean, what we did is we initially assigned, okay, this is our max profit. So here we know max profit equal to price array minus min price, and we also need to calculate the min price from every iteration. If price array of I is less than the previously calculated min price, and I is not equal to length minus 1, then min price equal to price array of I. Because min price, whatever we calculated, that might not be correct. We have to iterate and we have to keep checking what is the min price, and based on that we have to keep calculating the max profit. It's like you are trying to find out the maximum profit by diffing what is the min price from the overall array and what is the maximum profit we can get. Initially max profit we assigned the difference of first and the zeroth index. If we just talk about this, we assigned this, but later we start calculating, okay, is there any other element exist with min price which is less than this? If yes, then do the diff and try to calculate the min price and max profit. You keep subtracting the every element with the min price, which is 1, and keep comparing if it is greater than the max profit we already have. Okay, it's a simple one. Now we will talk about, so anagram number of, if you have given a single string or two string to check the both the strings are anagram, or there can be a problem where you have given n number of string and check if all the strings are anagram of one another or not. Anagram means the count of characters, the length of string should be equals. If this is coming, these both are anagram, but if you just increase this value, then these are not anagrams because the character count V is not same. Okay, so there may be a multiple string has been given to you to do the same. You need to compare and see if both string are anagram or not. So this we have already covered in the previous videos. I will just talk about the shortcut of it. So this is what we have done. We removed that, did a lowercase and comparing the length, and then iterating on to one single string array and checking if the each and every string of one array exists in another string array or not. Simple one, right? Or what you can do, you can actually sort and compare both the strings if both the strings are equals or not. It can be as simple as this. You got the both the strings, split, reverse, split, sort and join means you are actually sorting the characters so that you can get the all the characters in single order so that you can do triple equals. Okay. Now, last question in this video, we are going to talk about the matrix and rotation of matrix. Okay, matrix using arrays. So how can we build a simple matrix of 3 cross 3? Sorry. If this matrix we wanted to create, how can we do? Either we will just do a two different loops and we'll create a simple 2D array, something like this, right? Matrix, and we'll keep assigning whatever the default value we wanted to assign. If it is for 3 multiply 3, then we can create a 3 rows and 3 columns. Or a simple one is array of 3. I mean, this is just another way of creating new array. It should be array.fill. Yeah, so it is creating 3 rows and it is filling with another three arrays which are filled with 0. So it will create 3 cross 3 array of, I mean, nested array. Every element is filled with 0. Okay, so now our problem statement we wanted to talk about is string rotation clockwise or anti-clockwise. This is generic question which you might face, and it is very simple logic. So here we are doing 90 degree clockwise or anti-clockwise rotation. So here we see 1 2 3. So how, if we rotate it, then how, what it will become? 7 4 1, right? 90 degree rotation if you do clockwise, or anti-clockwise it will just reverse, right? So what actually we are doing, string simple rotation is all about replacing column with a row, right? Here we are replacing 4 with if you just do a string rotation, then first we have to just reverse each and every element. So if this is our input, if I will talk about, okay, if this string is our input, this is array in array, right? Now I will just iterate on to this matrix and I will try to reverse it. Okay, so this is our array. First we can just create a deep copy of this, okay, and we'll just call this rotate clockwise method. What we are doing is we are creating a deep copy of this json.stringify parse. You can also do using triple dot spread operator, and we are calling rotate clockwise. Okay, so what rotate clockwise method is doing, if we write it, const rotate clockwise, here we are getting a string, here we are getting a matrix. Okay, so first of all we'll get a matrix which is, we just need to call matrix.reverse. So after doing this matrix.reverse, you can just run a loop and replace I with the j, I mean row, convert row with the column. That's it. So that what we can do, we are actually swiping the element of I with j. Simple. I with I till matrix.length, j with till j dot I, right? J is 0, j is less than I. Here we are creating a temp of ij, and ij is getting assigned with ji. I mean, why we are swiping the element of row column with a column row, and this is it. Matrix will have the rotation. Okay, if you want to do a rotation in different ways, like rotation counterclockwise, then it will be a different approach, but on the same line. I will just put that so you will be able to understand. Here we are getting the matrix, right? Matrix.map we are doing. We are actually getting each and every row of matrix, and we are first reversing it. Then we are actually assigning ij with gi. That's it. So only difference here we are doing is the way of doing a reverse. Here we are doing a matrix reverse. Here we are iterating on each and every row, and then we are doing a reverse. And in the next video, we'll talk more about next set of array questions.